First and foremost, I want to give all praises and all glory to the true and living power, which is Yahweh Bahashem, Yahweh Shai, Bahashem Raka Kwadash. Yahweh is the true name of the Heavenly Father. Yahweh Shai is the true name of His only begotten Son, and there is no God beside them. And I want to give double honors to the apostles and elders of Great Millstone, who definitely rule well, and honors and citations to the hopeful elect. So in this lesson, real quick lesson, I just want to get into, you know, prayer, which is a very heavy, you know, of course, effective tool in this battle that we all are in, fighting to make it into the kingdom. And prayer is, you know, the most effective tool, all right, that we have to use. And I want to, it's pretty much going over the scripture right here, and figure might as well do a lesson on it. I'm going to read it in the easy English. Salakia. Okay, Khan. So this is James 5 and 16. It says, so tell each other about any wrong things that you have done. The Most High makes sick people well. So speak to Him on behalf of each other. You know, and that's beautiful right there. Of while we're in our prayers to the true and living power, Yahweh Bahashem Yahweh Shai. Okay, because like Yahweh Shai said in John the 4th chapter, that He seeks the true, that the Heavenly Father seeks the true worshipers to worship Him. So, prayer to the true and living power. All right, is essential, man. So, in praying, we have to make sure, you know, that we're praying to Yahweh Bahashem Yahweh Shai, and eventually, the hopeful elect, you know, are gonna come into that understanding, man, one way or another. So, continuing on, it says, but oh yeah, within the prayer, man. In our prayers, we should be praying for each other. And it's a very sincere and beautiful thing too, to pray for one another, because we got to remember what Yahweh Shai said, how He mentioned, you know, when I was in prison, You visited me. When I didn't have anything to eat, You gave me something to eat and to drink. And, you know, of course, the disciples asked Him, when was you in prison, and when was you like this and that? And He said, and Yahweh Shai said, of course, as we know, when you do it for each other, you do it for me as well. So for Yahweh Bahashem Yahweh Shai to hear our prayers for one another, that's like once again taking care of Yahweh Shai, which is pleasing to Yahweh Bahashem Yahweh Shai, man. And that's why the scriptures say, you know, happy are we, O Israel. Also showing forth that not all Israel is of Israel, but us that are of the hopeful elect. Happy are we, O Israel, for the things that are pleasing to the Lord are made known unto us. But if you're not interested in what's pleasing to the Lord, learning, like Yahweh Shai said, learn of me, for my yoke is easy and my burden is light. If you're not interested in learning what's pleasing to the Lord and then walking therein, then it's like you're a heathen. Because as Israelites, we're supposed to be tied in heavily with our power. Let me get a quick precept. I think it's Joshua 1 and 8. Life ain't about having as much fun as you possibly can. Not this lifetime. Not in this lifetime. It's not. This lifetime is about proving ourselves to Yahweh Bahashem Yahweh Shai that we're worthy to be amongst Him. Because that's in Luke 21 and 36. Once again, Yahweh Shai, speaking of prayer, Yahweh Shai said, watch and pray that Watch and pray that he, dang, let me get it. Because I know the Matthew is 26:41. That he may be accounted worthy to escape these things that shall come to pass. Yeah, just quote it. That he may be accounted worthy to escape these things that shall come to pass. And to stand before the Son of Man. You see? So this lifetime is about proving ourselves to be worthy when the Lord returns. Now, of course, we got to do this and that to continue to keep a roof over our head. But the primary goal is proving ourselves worthy to the Most High by way of being obedient to His Son, Yahweh Shai. Right? Not about just what? Ain't about just doing whatever the hell you want. So anyhow, this is Joshua 1:8. This book of the law shall not depart out of thy mouth, but thou shalt meditate therein day and night, that thou mayest observe to do according to all that is written therein. For then shalt thou make thy way prosperous, and then shalt thou have good success. So we're supposed to be meditating ultimately now in the spirit, day and night. It says the Most High, all right, back in James 5:16, so speak to him on behalf of each other. The Most High really listens to a person who obeys the Most High. And this is what I was like, this is what spawned me to want to do this lesson, because this is a tip right here on the quality of our prayers. Hell yeah, man. There's such thing as the quality of your prayer. Okay, we can increase the quality of our prayers, man. In the book of Tobit 12:8 says, prayer is good with fasting and alms. Roughly paraphrasing, prayer is good with much fasting and alms, man. So, you know, if it's all about pleasing the Lord in this lifetime, I mean, and always, always and forever, of course, but I say that to say, man, you know, it's not about having, like, fun and shit, man, here. It's more so about pleasing the Lord, but the time is going to come where it is about having fun. You know, when the Lord blesses us with the kingdom, man, he said that, in the book of Psalms, 1,000 of your, well, matter of fact, let me get it. Psalms 84:10. For a day in thy courts is better than 1,000. I had rather be a doorkeeper in the house of my power than to dwell in the tents of wickedness. See? So a day in the, when we're in the kingdom, is going to be better than 1,000 of our best days here, man. So that's how fun it's 1,000 of your best days, period, man. So that's how fun it's going to be in the kingdom. But right now, it's about proving ourselves. That's even 2 Corinthians 13:5. Prove yourselves. Know you not your own selves? And making sure we proving ourselves by doing what's pleasing to the Lord. So here it is. We know that prayer. Man, see? Oh, man. That's why it's a very beautiful thing to be a part of Great Millstone, you know? To know that we're Israelites, one, is a very great thing. Makes you a better person, period. It changes your diet to where you're not eating abominable foods. It, it brings order in life into our lives. Your life becomes more stable and disciplined and more spiritual. But then, you know, you want the 100% truth, man. Which is why you got to be under the doctrine of Great Millstone, because that is the doctrine of 100% truth. Right? And, yeah, Salakia, I lost my train of thought. I was getting on to one of the main roads, but let me get back into this. Oh, yeah, because I was saying, we're really taught to learn of the Lord here, man, you know? We're not free-for-all, and we're not just going to a damn building, dancing and BSing, and then just going home, not learning nothing. You know, here in Great Millstone, man, you actually learn, and learn of the Lord, and get to know the Lord, man. Know the Lord for ourselves. There ain't no, not my pastor. We're all pastors, man. Here in Great Millstone. That's why we all do our lessons. But yeah, we got elders, but we ain't no, not my pastor spirit. No, we know these things for ourselves. So it says, the Most High listens to a person who obeys the Most High. See that? So that's a beautiful thing to know. When we, you know, begin our prayers to the Lord, that he really listens to someone that obeys him. So the more we obey and the more we be pleasing to the Lord, the more he's willing to hear us, man. And that's powerful right there to know that. And even more to apply it, man. So it says the Most High does powerful things when someone like that ask him to. So we, you see the benefits, man, in obeying the Most High, Yahweh Bashmal Shai. Man, it comes with benefits, man. Just like Isaiah the 65th chapter, it comes with benefits to be a servant of the Lord. My servant shall eat and rejoice, but ye shall be hungry. You know, and cry for how and cry and howl for vexation of spirit. You know, so I just wanted to share and push forth this powerful tool as I was going over it myself. And yeah, man, you know, when we pray, it's more than just praying. You know, there's factors in that can increase the quality of prayers, man. And that's very good to know. So Lord willing, this was edifying. And with that, I'm going to say shalom.